This is a DC to DC buck converter I got from banggood.com. There's a link in the description. It's model B3606, made by MingHe. It has both voltage and current limiting capabilities. I've been using it for the past 6 months without any issues. Commercial bench power supplies are pretty expensive, but if you have any DC power supply, even if unregulated, as long as it can provide the maximum voltage and the current you require, this will work great as an alternative. This is not to say that it is as good as a professional bench supply, but if your application isn't very sensitive, it will do the job. The basic operation of a buck converter is switching between these two states very quickly. In this module's specifications, it gives a 150 kHz frequency and a maximum ripple of 50 mV. The input voltage range is 6 to 40 volts, and it needs to be at least 1.5 volts above the desired output. The output voltage range is 0 to 36 volts, and the output current range is 0 to 6 amps, but for over 5 amps, you may need additional cooling. The conversion efficiency is up to 92%, which is a lot better than using linear regulators. Right now, I'm powering this from an ATX power supply through a boost converter set at 30 volts, which I'll review in a future video. You can tell whether the display shows volts or amps by the position of the decimal point. This is volts, and this is amps. Voltage resolutions is 10 millivolts. Current resolution is 1 milliamp. As you can tell, there are 4 buttons, a 4-digit display, and 3 LEDs. The buttons are set, down, up, and OK. The green LED shows that the device is in constant voltage mode, the yellow one is for constant current, and the red one shows that the device is outputting power. This is a voltmeter connected directly to the output, and this is an ammeter connected through a 10 ohm resistor. Let's set the buck converter to output 2.5 volts and 0.5 amp. We set the voltage level at 2.5. We press set. Press set again to switch between displaying voltage and current. Now we're in the current. We go down to 500 milliamps. Press set again. Press OK to output. As you can see by the red LED and the green LED shows that we're in constant voltage mode. On the display, you can switch between voltage and current by pressing OK. You can adjust the values while outputting. So if we drop the voltage, you can see it. Or switch to current, and if we drop the current limit to below the current consumption, which right now is 291 milliamps, so we drop the level below at around 100, you can see that the device went into constant current mode, indicated by the yellow LED. Let's raise the current limit to 0.5 amp again. The device goes back into constant voltage mode. If we connect a 1 ohm resistor in parallel, you can see that the device goes into constant current again. Which is limited at 510 milliamps. To stop the device from outputting, you press set. you can have the display cycle between showing the voltage and current values by holding down the OK button. There are three hidden functions that you can access by holding down OK while powering the device. The device cycles between them and you release the OK button at the desired function. Function 0 will have the device outputting as soon as it has power. So, as you can see, if I turn the device back on, it's immediately outputting. To turn this functionality off, we go into function 0 again. Function 1 brings up the power and capacity parameters. You can see this shows the current power consumption, and now we have the capacity in amp hours, which should increase. Yes. Function 2 will have the device cycling the display through all four parameters. You can stop the display cycling by just holding the OK button. And you can manually cycle. If you have enabled function 1, you gain access to 10 memory locations where you can save and bring up later settings. Let's save something in memory location 6. So, we set our desired values. Voltage 7 volts, current, and if we press set again, this is the location from where we bring up settings, and this is where we save. So let's go to memory location 6 and we press OK. So now we change to a random value. And if we want to bring up location 6, we have our saved settings. In addition to the three previous functions, there are an additional 6 that you can access by holding down the set button. I wasn't able to find any information about them, but I assume that the first 4 are used for testing purposes, because on the first function, you can cycle between displaying 2 volts and the current being limited to 200 milliamps, or displaying 24 volts with the current being limited at the same value. Function number 2 displays 200 milliamps or 2.8 amps. Function number 3 goes to 2 volts but displays the actual value, so if this modifies it will show you that. Also, it goes to 24 volts with no load, but if I have my 10 ohm load, it will current limit at 200 milliamps. Function number 4 is similar to the previous ones, just that this time it displays the current. So the first one is limited at 200 milliamps, and the second would be limited at 2.8 amps, but it voltage limits at 5 volts. Function number 5 switches between allowing you to save or not save values, and function number 6 goes to a factory reset. Let me try that again. Function number 6, and we can factory reset. As I previously said, I use this as a bench power supply. To me, the most important functionality is the ability to limit the current. As you can see here, I'm shorting this out and I'm limiting at 1 amp, which also allows me to do this.